All right, welcome to this tutorial. We are actually going to be introducing what we call the Simple Microcontroller series. This is a series that was thought up by Sergey, one of our awesome engineers, and he always loves a challenge. So he was thinking, how can we learn more about microcontrollers and then show how much impressive stuff you can do using the simplest microcontroller possible? So that was his dream, and he's the one behind these tutorials, and he did all of the writing stuff. So like all the tutorials that we do, we have this video, and then we have our tutorial on circuitbread.com. So if you want to go over it in a different pace, or you want to have a slightly different perspective on it, it's a great way to learn it a little bit more in depth. So with these super simple microcontroller tutorials, we're going to show how you can do the more basic light up an LED, a line following robot, or a robot that you can control remotely, stuff like that, all with one of the most simple microcontrollers available. So one of the benefits of doing this, and one of the reasons we want to do this, is because we are so used to Arduinos, and we're so used to all of these awesome tools that make it a lot easier, which is great, but we sometimes miss what's going on at the lower level. So by doing this, we're going to go down to the lowest level of interfacing with a microcontroller to show what's going on with the registers, what's going on with the code, and what is exactly happening to give you the results that you want. So even though this is going to be very simple and we're going to try and make it as easy as possible, if you do have a background in electronics, just your typical power ground, resistor, all that sort of stuff, and a basic understanding of Boolean algebra, basically digital logic and how that works, that is going to go a long way to helping you with this. Again, I don't think it'll be necessary, but it will definitely help you and maybe make it so you can only go through the tutorial once and be good to go versus having to go through it once or twice or three times to be like, ah, now it finally makes sense. So we're going to be using a microchip PIC10F200. And the reason we chose this microcontroller is because it is extremely simple. It's one of the most basic microcontrollers that we could find. It's also extremely cheap. Like this DIP package is a little bit over 50 cents. And if you get a surface mount package, then you're looking at more like a quarter or less for these things in units of one. And then of course, if you get thousands or tens of thousands, they get even cheaper. So that's one of the reasons we like these. And also, like I mentioned, there's different packages for these. So this is the DIP, which we like to use because it's a lot easier to use with a breadboard. But if you want to actually integrate this into a smaller, more streamlined unit and design your own PCB and stuff like that, you can use the SOT23 packages, which are absolutely tiny and still give you the full functionality of this DIP8 package. And just to give you an idea of how much smaller and simpler this is, this microcontroller, you can only have 256 words of flash memory, so you can only really execute 256 commands, whereas with an Arduino Uno, which is really quite simple, it has 32,000 or 32K of flash memory. So that is a huge difference, and that shows you exactly how simple this thing is. Yet with this, we'll still be able to make remote control robots and other cool things, which we'll get to in later tutorials. As part of doing this, part of the simplicity, we're actually going to do our code in assembly, which can strike fear into some people, but we're going to keep it very simple. And one of the benefits of assembly is, again, not only do you learn at a lower level what's going on here, so it's a great learning and training tool, but it's actually very efficient. You can save a lot of code space and it runs faster because there's not a lot of extraneous commands going on that are put in by other compilers. For example, if you were to use an Arduino to do an LED blinky program, it would use almost a kilobyte of programming space to just blink an LED on and off, whereas you can do that same thing in assembly for about 15 words. So again, just an order of magnitude or two different in how much space it uses. So that's one of the awesome things about assembly. And again, assembly, it's not something a whole lot of people use anymore. And we don't expect you to use this commercially or anything like this, but it's really great for understanding what's going on underneath everything. So you get a more intuitive sense of how a microcontroller works. And one thing I do want to say, just to make it very clear, this is not an anti-Arduino thing. Yeah, Arduinos aren't as efficient. They're a lot bigger. They're a lot more expensive, but they are amazing for doing quick prototypes and just getting stuff done. We love them. We use them all the time. We use them in a lot of our tutorials. So don't get that impression whatsoever. This is not a replacement. This is to help with the understanding of what's going on. So with that, let's talk about what our next steps are. This is just an introduction to what our intent is with this series, but next steps are we are going to talk about the conceptual ideas that we need to understand in terms of the hardware, setting up the circuit, as well as the conceptual ideas of what's going on inside the microcontroller, the registers, the IOs, and how they all work like back and forth. So we're gonna get more into that over the next couple tutorials, as well as going over some of the basics of the assembly language so that when we start getting into the codes, it's not just completely throwing you off. And that's it. Once we do those conceptual ideas and kind of lay that foundation, we're gonna go immediately into doing more exciting projects where we're turning on LEDs, blinking LEDs, again, just robots, because who doesn't like to make something that moves around back and forth? So that's what we're gonna get to eventually, and that will be the culmination of this tutorial, is having those robots that can do really powerful things with a very, very simple microcontroller. So we hope you enjoyed this video, hope you enjoyed this introduction, and it gets you excited for the tutorials that are gonna come to explain more about how we can do amazing things with a simple microcontroller. If you like this video, give it a like and subscribe to our channel. We'll catch you later.